When it comes to running a turbocharged race car at very high altitudes, such as here at Pikes Peak International Hill Climb, most people can understand that the low barometric air pressure we see at high altitude results in a reduction in engine power. What's often overlooked, though, is that the low air density at high altitude also results in a reduction in the efficiency of the cooling systems on the engine. This includes the radiator, as well as the intercooler and oil coolers. And this is a battle for a lot of the teams that have built and developed cars at or close to sea level and then brought them up here to the high altitude of Pikes Peak. The start line here is around about 9,500 feet, and at the peak, it's a little over 14,000 feet. We're here supporting Tony Quinn's Highlands Motorsport Park Ford Focus, which runs a twin turbocharged Nissan VR38 sourced from a Nissan R35 GTR. We found that during practice and testing, the engine coolant temperature was a significant issue, with it consistently running at or above 100 degrees Celsius. Now, while there's not necessarily anything wrong with this, the lower that we can get that engine coolant temperature, the better for both engine power and engine reliability. Now, there's a limited number of things that we can do once we're actually here at the mountain, and clearly one of the great fixes for this would have been fitting a larger cooling system to the car. That was out of the question, so we looked at alternatives. One of the first fixes that was incorporated was a water spray system that sprays a fine mist of water over the radiator once the engine coolant temperature exceeds 100 degrees Celsius. We are a little bit limited here on water capacity, so in order to conserve that water, we're only spraying when the engine temperature exceeds our threshold and when the driver's throttle position exceeds about 75%. On top of this, though, we're also using some of the functionality inside the MoTeC M150 ECU in order to try and help bring those engine coolant temperatures down. Now, anything we can do here is really around reducing the amount of engine power. As we reduce the engine power, this reduces the heat that the engine has to reject into the cooling system. So there's two strategies we're using here. First of all, once the engine coolant temperature exceeds 105 degrees Celsius, we're starting to reduce the boost pressure targets. So by reducing the boost pressure, this is making less power from the engine and achieving our aims. The other aspect here is that, again, once the engine coolant temperature exceeds 105 Celsius, we're also starting to target a richer air-fuel ratio. We're physically injecting more fuel into the engine, and this fuel is passing through the combustion chamber unburned, and it helps absorb heat inside the combustion chamber and reduce the engine temperature. So these are just some of the little tricks that we can use with a modern ECU to help ensure engine reliability and help try our very best to maintain a reliable engine coolant temperature as the car runs up the hill. Of course, the deficit here, or the downside, is that these two measures will reduce the engine power, which is going to have a negative effect on the engine performance, power, and the car's time up the hill. Of course, it's much more important to get to the finish line rather than try and make maximum power and have the engine overheat halfway up.
If you like that video, make sure you give it a thumbs up, and if you're not already a subscriber, make sure you're subscribed. We release a new video every week. And if you like free stuff, we've got a great deal for you. Click the link in the description to claim your free spot to our next live lesson. You'll learn about performance engine building and EFI tuning, and you'll also have the chance to ask questions, which I'll be answering live. Remember, it's 100% free, so follow the link to claim your spot.